Good morning and welcome to day 6 of our 21 day prayer and devotion. Thank you for joining with many during this morning devotions. I'm sure God is ministering to you each day and encouraging you to move from one level to another level this new season that God is ushering us into. We talked about how God invites us to join in this new season and how He wants us to see the new thing that He has in store for us and is in fact doing within our lives. Today I want to talk about, in fact over the next few days I want to talk about, how do we maximize the new things that God is doing in our lives. The first thing that we need to do in order to maximize the new things that God is doing in our lives is to set new priorities. Psalmist in Psalm 27 verses 4 sings like this. He says, "One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in His temple." In other words, this David psalmist is saying that there is one thing that I desire in my life. I mean, more than anything else in my life, my job, my finances, my future, more than all these things, there's one thing that I desire, that is to spend time in the presence of God. That should be our new priority if we want to maximize new things in our lives. Daniel is a classic example of how he prioritized the presence of God, spending time in the presence of God more than anything else, even more than his own life. When he was in the danger of being caught and thrown into a lion's den, he still made sure he took time out and spent time with God. In Daniel chapter 6 verses 10, when Daniel learned the law had been signed, he went home and knelt down as usual in his upstairs room. With his windows open towards Jerusalem, he prayed 3 times a day, just as he had always done, giving thanks to his God. I mean, that's brilliant. First of all, his life is in danger, and the law that will put his life in danger has already been passed. And yet he decided that he's not going to stop what he always had done in his life, that is to spend time with God, to worship Him. And beautiful thing is that he chose to worship God and give thanks to God in spite of all the things that are going against his life. What a conviction, isn't it? What we need to realize is this, that while we do know the importance of the presence of God in our lives, we need to have true conviction within us in order to make that as the priority in our lives, spending time with Him. Two completely different people who enter into a romantic relationship can become similar because of the time that they spend in each other's presence. Ask any married person who is still in love with their spouse that the more they spend time with each other, the more they become one. They start thinking alike, they start saying words alike, they start even dressing alike almost. With the same passion, you could see the same passion inside them, same commitment towards anything. It's very interesting. The same can be said about our relationship with God. You grow to be more like Him as you spend time with Him. Because Daniel believed and relied on God, here is what happens when you spend time in the presence of God, making it a priority, is that he was preserved from all the harm that the law was going to bring to him. In fact, not only he was preserved, he himself caused an entire nation to turn and worship God because of his commitment, his conviction towards in another presence of God. His conviction gave him the courage to take time to spend time with God. See, it's not just the quantity of time that we spend with Him; it's the quality of the time that we need to, that is necessary in spending time with Him. So, what do we do? What do I focus during my times of prayer and worship? And that's where the David song, in fact, helps us in Psalm 27 verses 4 that we have just read. What I think David is trying to suggest to us is this, that in the presence of God, the first thing, that the first foremost thing that we do, we must do, is to spend time to worship Him. Spend time giving thanks to Him, worship Him, and enjoy Him for who He is. And then we open ourselves to listen to His voice. You know, of course, we're going to share our needs with Him. We're going to talk about our day with Him. We're going to tell, present all our needs to Him. But enjoying who God is in His presence can actually change the quality of our relationship with Him. So I want to ask you a question today before we close this devotion. What makes it hard for you to spend time consistently with God each day? What are the things that are stopping you from spending time with God qualitatively each day? How can you change your daily schedule in order to spend more time with God? Think about it. And if you can list those things that you can actually rearrange and make time for God, then the time that you spend with God would become of quality and relationship with God becomes better. Now know this, this is the priority. This is the most important thing that you need to do in your daily life. I pray and ask God to give you wisdom to rearrange your daily life, to rearrange things that need to be put in right order so that you can spend more time qualitatively with God. God bless you.